When a girl breaks up with a guy, there are two types of reasons. There are the reasons she gives, and there are the reasons she has. The reasons a girl gives are usually something practical, like timing, incompatible future plans, or God has not destined us to be together. I hope you understand. Then, there's the reasons she actually has for breaking up. A list of reasons that are so hidden, she might not ever really share them with her friends, let alone her own diary. These reasons are generally valid, but more shallow. The red flags that she's embarrassed to call red flags. These reasons aren't shared in order to protect the guy. Courtesy calls. Sure, she wanted to protect me, but she didn't realize what was going to happen next.
Come in.
10?
Hey, Steve.
10.
You want some stoop?
Hey, buddy.
Hi.
How you doing?
That's mine.
Yeah, I know, it is, I know. What are you up to, huh?
I'm just
playing some video games?
Mm-hmm.
Alright, I'm gonna take the controller now, Ted, okay?
I'm not done.
Ted, I'm gonna take this.
It's half
Ted,
time.
Ted, give it! Ted, how old are these goldfish? Ted, this says 2011.
They're still good.
Ted, this needs to stop. We gotta get you out of here. Ted! We're leaving!
Where are we going?
Isn't it kind of funny the stuff people say about breakups sometimes afterwards, like, Ted, there's more fish in the sea, or Ted, there's more stars in the sky, or Dad will always be there to make another omelet, you know, like Pinterest kind of stuff.
Pinterest? You have Pinterest?
Dude, I want to be able to plan my dream wedding too, alright? I need to know how to make burlap runners and hanging lanterns.
At least you'll have a wedding. I don't know, man, I just don't get it.
Dude, I feel you. Remember Crazy Stacy from freshman year? Crazy Stacy.
What? Excuse me?
Stacy, I'm sorry, okay? I gotta go to Biff now.
You said no, it was Stacey, forever!
Stacy, stop! Stacy's life, Stacy! Stacy, stop! Stacy!
Dude, anyway, like, we're here now. We're just gonna chill out. We're gonna have a lot of Lucky Charms. Watch Transformers. It's gonna be fine.
All right, let's go inside. Hold on.
You know, I'm kind of glad I never brought her up here. I always wanted to, just never got around to it. Our schedules didn't match up. She's always busy. Like, she's busy with hanging out with her DSG, or leading her floor with the CLC, or studying at the BGC. I don't know. She would even study in Anderson Commons. Like, I don't know. Or work, you know?
She had a job?
Well, no, like, not like work, but like work, you know. Classwork, homework, schoolwork. Life gets busy.
I think that's garbage. I mean, we all have work to do. At least she wasn't like an RA or one of those people who ticket for public safety. But otherwise, we're all busy.
Hey, Ted, here's your coffee.
Thanks, man. You got any sugar?
Man up and drink it black.
Yeah. This was always a good spot for the bros.
Amen. And honestly, Ted, Katie was fine, but I was never a big fan. I mean, she was so... Maggie, you know?
Well, she was worried about me.
No, but she always told you how to dress.
No, like, she was helping me match.
Remember those gloves she would always wear all the time?
Her hands got cold. She had tiny fingers.
I mean, I'll say this in her defense. Katie was gorgeous. I mean, If we weren't friends, like, I would definitely consider pursuing her intentionally.
You literally have a girlfriend right now.
No, we're not serious.
You're signed up to ring the bell.
Ted, we're not talking about me, okay? This is about you. You're single now? That means freedom. Have you ever considered, dating a freshman? I mean, isn't that why you did orientation committee? That's why I did it.
I don't know, dude. The Swiss life is just not for me.
Fair. Alright, what about senior girls? More mature?
I don't know. They kind of seem desperate, don't you think?
Huh?
I'm not really ready anyway. It's just too soon.
Alright. Well, until you are ready. I'm here for you, buddy.
Thanks, man.
Hey, who's my big guy?
I'm your big guy.
Who's my big guy?
I'm your big guy.
There it is. Come on, let's watch some football.
All right.
You silly goose. This is enough. Good grief, man. All right, we just gotta shake this one off, okay?
Okay.
We gotta shake it off, all right? A one, a two. A one, two, three, four.
I'm sorry, excuse me. Do you have a dollar I could borrow?
Yep.
Thanks. Oh, the stupid washing machines in my dorm broke down.
Yeah. Yeah, here you go.
Thanks.
At least here, no one's gonna, like, fold your underwear for you, so it'll be good.
Yeah. Thanks. Oh my goodness, did you hear that Dan and Jane got engaged yesterday?
I'm not surprised.
They've been dating for 6 months.
They're in love.
We've been dating for 8 months.
Ted, how are you doing, like, with everything?
What do you mean?
You know, with, like, seeing Katie around campus and...
Oh, no.
I feel like you've really...
I'm fine.
Adjusted.
You look like you've adjusted.
Yeah.
I'm totally... Katie's done. That's...
Okay.
No, that's good.
In the past.
It looks like you've gained a new, perspective.
What do you mean?
Like a new...
Look, a new look.
Yeah, you got a new look.
Uh-huh.
Are you talking about my beard?
That's not a beard, Ted. That's a mistake.
I know what you mean. I think I figured it out. Like, time to move on.
Yes.
Time to move on.
Come on.
Time to move forward.
Time to move forward.
Time to move to Honey Rock and just enjoy the North Woods and spend every night by myself by the fire.
living in a cabin till I'm old and wrinkly.
No, Ted, that's not what,
not what we're talking about.
You've been doing great. I know it's been a hard 3 months. It's been a hard 3 months, and I know, and mostly because Katie was being totally
Okay. She wasn't. She just wasn't handling things the best that she could.
Yeah, I mean, whatever. I don't know.
Okay, well, we're happy for you.
We're happy for you.
Yeah.
Thanks. What do you mean? Like,
well, we've been talking, and we just feel like maybe you should start looking again.
Yeah.
I'm good.
Has anyone caught your eye recently?
Not a single person in this world.
Look, okay, well, if he says there's nobody, there's nobody.
No one's caught his eye yet.
Yet? Oh, my goodness. I can't wait for you to find
the one.
She's
gonna fish
and
see.
I know, and then we can take them on double dates. Oh, my God, there's
no! I'm fine. Seriously. I don't want to go on double dates with you guys. I don't want to be in a relationship. I just want to be left by myself. Just leave me alone. I'm good and happy with how I am and what I'm becoming.
Ted, look at you. You haven't showered in days.
Oh, that's so gross.
You stopped shaving.
I still shower.
You sit at your desk all day. You watch Mythbusters constantly on Netflix. And you clearly don't do your laundry anymore.
I just buy new clothes.
What? Ted, we need to get you back out there.
I don't want to. Dumb.
Ted, what about one saga date?
Absolutely no saga.
Why doesn't he go to saga?
Saga with Katie.
Oh.
Just one date. I'll pay you.
No. You're not gonna have some girl find out that you paid him to go on a date with her.
Yeah.
No.
You're not gonna pay me.
I'll pay your fruit fine.
Okay, wait, what's the fruit fine?
This is my heart. This is my heart. Often insecure,
you found me lying on the floor. Where were you? Lost and insecure, you found me. Found me lying on the floor. Surround me. Why'd you have to wait? Where were you? Just a little late. You found me.
You can't take this moment from me. No.
$500 for 100 dates.
Are you serious? Like, you'll pay everything?
I don't just have $500 to burn. If I'm gonna put in the money, you're gonna put in the time. $500, 100 dates by the end of the year. Or no deal.
I mean, it sounds worth it if he's serious about it.
I don't know. Okay, fine. I'll do it.
Yeah?
Yeah. Sure.
Okay.
Okay?
Yeah, and I'll help. I'll pay $250 and I'll help arrange him the dates. Yeah. Yeah.
That's why she's my girlfriend.
We're gonna do
it. Yeah, we're gonna do it. Okay.
Yeah.
All right. All right.
Yesterday,
Ted asked me if Stoop serves breakfast. He's a broken man. Find him some dates. Let's find him some dates.
Let's go, boys. Let's go. Hey.
Look, I explained that.
Good. Ted, I want to welcome you to the headquarters for your next 100 dates.
Wow.
Beautiful, isn't it?
Yeah, that's great.
We've used it before.
When?
How do you think Jeff Arthur got Hannah Swanson to date him?
Oh.
Hey, are you guys even working?
Yes. Yeah. 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 Yeah,
I got it. Where are the hashtag reports?
I got them right here.
Where's my phone? Mission trip status.
She's been on James Marino's side.
She's been
average.
That's good. What does this graph mean?
Soggy dates versus
gosh dang it. Don't you mention it.
She's a boyfriend.
She transferred to Moody.
Yep.
Yeah.
What do you think?
Yeah, looks great. Is this really gonna work though? Like,
Ted, I've been your best friend for 3 years. I'm not gonna lead you astray, man.
Hey, Steve, I think I got a lead on the Canna Hellner case.
Canna Hellner? She's cute.
And she's dating someone. Stevie Kellogg.
Stevie Kellogg? Senior? Motorcycle?
Yeah.
Gosh, he's so cool. Alright, well, besides a few minor problems, alright? This is good. This is really good.
Yeah, that's also your girlfriend, Mindy.
Kowalski! Was this you?
Yeah, my bad, dude.
Gosh, dang it. Alright. I know there's a few problems, but...
Boss, I think we got the first lead.
Thank you, you beautiful man. Date number one.
Mindy? She's still there.
This is not funny. This is not funny. And you're hillbilly proud, then you know what I'm talking about. Let me hear you say, truck, yeah, I wanna get it jacked up, yeah, let's crank it on up, yeah, with a little bit of luck I can find me a girl with a truck, yeah, we can love it on up, yeah, till the sun comes up, yeah, and if you think it's life I love.
You can't say no to cookie dough. So, what part of Wisconsin are you from?
Just south of Madison. I live in some suburbs. It's not really that different from Wheaton.
So, do you really like cheese?
Everyone in Wisconsin likes cheese.
You think I'm really into cheese?
I hear it's a big export from that part, that state, or whatever it is.
Yeah, okay. It's pretty big there, I guess. So why biology?
Why not?
I mean, pre-med, animal research, what?
You know, grumpy high school teacher, actually. What about you? Why anthro?
Sorry, what did you say?
Anthropology. Why study anthro?
Sorry, hang on. You just look really good in front of the mural right there.
Okay.
What's for Instagram?
Like this?
Do you have one?
Nope, don't have an Instagram.
Really? Do you have a Twitter?
Nope, no Twitter.
A Facebook?
I have a Facebook, I just don't ever use it.
What?
I never use Facebook.
Oh. Yeah, okay.
Do you want to get something to eat? I could get some chocolate.
I could go for some cheese.
So my buddies gave me like this long list of questions
to ask you.
And like some of them are just like really ridiculous.
Let me hear them. Wait, no, come on, give me one. I'm ready.
Okay. Oh, this one's not that bad.
Okay.
If there were three things in this world that you couldn't live without, mm-hmm. that weren't faith, family, friends, or food, what would they be?
Bike rides.
Mm.
Autumn.
Same.
Wait, hold on a sec. You just put it right here.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I just wanna take a picture.
Yeah, sure. So, autumn. Is that your favorite season?
Yeah, like a different season.
What was the third thing you said?
Hold on, just hold on. Could you move your hand out of the shot?
Yeah.
That's good.
From that point on, she just let loose. She started taking pictures of literally everything, from chocolates to little antiques, and not to mention her Twitter was blowing up. And what the heck is a Vine? Did you know they have Vines now? Like mini video Instagrams? Speaking of Instagram, there are way too many CrossFitters posting their workouts. Chill out. Hashtag WOD, hashtag FitFam, hashtag Suns Out, Guns Out. Hashtag I'm getting off topic. I'm not taking another girl out if she's more attracted to her phone than me. Tweet that. Let me get this clear.
Okay.
You're a philosophy and Bible major. You lead DSG.
Mm-hmm.
You play the violin, and somehow you find time on the weekends to go tutor kids downtown Chicago.
You're making this sound so much better than it actually is.
So basically, you still do all of those things that you wrote down in your college application about your leadership experience in high school.
No, that is not true. If I actually did all those things, I would probably be part of the cup stacking club and the recycling club.
And I'd still be part of like a YouTube cooking channel.
Well, then I'd still be a part of Hardcore Parkour Club. Oh my gosh!
Yeah, me too.
What are you doing?
No, I actually used to be in the CrossFit Club too, so.
Oh yeah, well, I used to farm goldfish.
Really? Mm-hmm. Well, I still have big muscles.
Oh, well then, I used to be part of the Save the Whales Club.
I used to be a part of Save the Dinosaurs Clubs. Oh. It didn't work out too well.
Okay, I can't beat that anymore. Okay, yeah.
Do you ever face like a negative stigma for being a Bible and philosophy major?
Yeah, I mean, I guess I do sometimes, but what are you gonna do, people, you know?
Yeah. I mean, I get some of the weirdest questions sometimes. Like, I'm pre-med,
mm-hmm.
and people always ask me, like, are you gonna be a doctor missionary in Africa? Or, like, are you gonna marry a nurse?
Wow,
or,
yeah.
Or, what's your favorite character on Grey's Anatomy? Like, I don't watch Grey's Anatomy.
That happens to me all the time, too. Like, people always ask me, like, oh, what's your view on predestination? Or what do you think about whether we're born into sin or whether you're born by sin? Like, how am I supposed to know?
Classic predestination.
But really, what do you think?
About what?
About predestination. It's an important, like, thing to have an opinion about, don't you think?
Yeah, I mean, I'm not, like, an expert or anything. I mean, that's a long conversation.
I have time.
Yeah, like, we were born into this sinful world.
Wait, innately by sin, so you actually think we're born sinful. Does the Bible say anything about that?
Does it? I don't...
I mean, well, what I think is that Adam wasn't created sinful, like, he was born sinless. And that means, like, that someone's DNA can't change just because you had sin, so that means children can't be born in sin. And so if you think about it, like, suppose a kid was born in sin, and suppose, like, everyone's DNA...
She just kept talking and talking and talking. It was like Bith 111 all over again. John Calvin this, Augustine that, Bonhoeffer... Oh, and not to mention our patron saint, J.R.R.
our Tolkien, the Narnia guy. Is this what people normally talk about on a first date?
How could you even think that? But, you know, does that ring a bell for you? Do you get it now?
Yeah, that was really eye-opening. Yeah.
How many kids do you want?
What?
Like, what? She asked me how many kids I wanted to have. And what Bible names I would use to name them if they were a boy or a girl. What is it with these girls? Always like asking about marriage, or always asking about like how many kids you want to have, or like...
Nebuchadnezzar.
What are you talking about?
Methuselah? I'm looking at top Bible names.
Yeah. It's not funny. I don't know, man. I think I'm done with this whole dating thing. I'm out.
No, you're not.
Yeah, I am.
No, you're not.
Yeah, I am.
No, you're not.
Yeah, I am.
Do you have $500?
No, I don't.
Ah, well, I think I have your plans for this Saturday night.
Well, this is not where I expected you to end up.
I know, I'm so sorry. I totally forgot Chick-fil-A was closed on Sunday.
No, don't worry about it. This has been really great, honestly. Yeah. I really enjoyed it.
Me too.
Yeah. There's something like a Wheaton experience and like getting to know people like this, like having conversations, and people are just so genuine and like they pay attention to you, and it's just so great. Anyways, I'm really
there
glad
she
that
was, sitting right across from me, the most beautiful girl at Wheaton, the woman in my dreams. Could this really be? Could this actually work? Wait a minute. What? What is she doing here? Ugh, flirting in public? Really? Might as well be a lobby couple. Aw, oh, man. She always wanted me to go to the gym. He definitely lifts. And that beard! It's so full! I wish I could grow that. Wow, she really looks like she's enjoying herself. Well, you know what? I'm enjoying myself, too.
Work. And,
what?
Yeah, I hope it's okay with you that, like, this just isn't really what I'm looking for. And is that all right with you?
Yeah, that's totally, yeah, that works.
Okay, good, I'm glad.
It's all good.
Thank you. Yeah. I mean, but I really enjoyed our time, though. Yeah.
Yeah.
Is that any good?
Yeah, it's all right.
Mind if I join?
No, go ahead. You want some?
Sure. Listen, Ted, I know you think this is going to help something, but we got to get you cleaned up, man.
Listen, I don't need any more of your help. You've done enough. Thanks, though.
Come on, Ted, I can't leave like this. Just let me...
No.
Let me help you. Give me the peanut butter.
No.
Come on. This place is a mess, man.
It's fine. It's pretty clean right now.
No! No! Stop, Ted! No! No! No. Thank you. Please just put it down, okay? Okay? God, Ted, no! No! Ted! Enough! You're a mess! Pull it together! Jeez! Look at this! How old is this?
Sunday night. I don't know.
Ted, it's Thursday!
I know, I'm a mess.
Hey. Who's my big guy?
I'm your big guy.
Hey! Who's my big guy?
I'm your big guy.
I'm not gonna let you go through this alone, buddy. Alright? We're gonna take this one thing at a time. First, let's do some laundry.
My underwear, get that off.
Okay.
Hey, Stevie. What's up? Just doing laundry. Why? Have I heard of who? No. Who's that? No. No more dates for me, dude. Nope. 100 and done. Just like we agreed to. Yeah. I'm sure she's very nice. Yeah. Hey, Hey, I'll call you right back. Hey.
Hi. I don't know if you remember this or me, but I owe you, so.
Oh, yeah.
There you go.
Thanks. Yeah.
See ya.
Okay, yeah.
Bye.
See ya.